Hello, queens and kings. It's Elo. Welcome. Tonight, I'll be coloring one of these velvet coloring sheets. There are four in the pack, so I'll be picking four. And I'll be using these Optimus felt tip pens. Quick drying, no bleed ink, medium point. Blue, green, orange, pink, dark pink. It looks a bit red, but it's dark pink for sure. And these colors as well, pastels. I think pastel colors are my favorite. Purple, light blue, teal, yellow, light pink, maybe peach, light pink, like I want to say berry, but I don't. Just call it medium pink. Okay. Okay. So let's open these up, shall we? I went shopping at the dollar store. But anyway, there's the cake, which I'm not super attracted to coloring right now. And then there's the coffee cup. Smoke swirls. But again, I'm not super drawn to this one either. Moving on. Ooh, seahorse. Yeah, I think this one is the one. Oh, I just love sea creatures. Okay. Did you know that seahorses are one of the slowest moving sea creatures? They don't move very fast. So let's just see what's underneath. But I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be coloring this beauty. The butterflies. Like on the cover. Three butterflies. Well, I like these as well. But I think the seahorse wins. Okay. Maybe I'll do another video. Coloring the rest of them. But tonight it will be the seahorse. Okay, let's up to the colors. The packs never open up like I want them to. There we go. Oh, that was loud. I might have to edit that out. New pens are a pleasure. Pleasure of mine. Oh, this one opened up a bit better. I love new pens. Oh, they're so satisfying. Okay. I wish they weren't so noisy on the table. Maybe I'll put a towel. One second. Where to begin? What color to choose first? It's so exciting. Okay. I think I'm going to go for pink. If you can hear that, that's my dog dreaming. Ooh, look at how fine this bandit is. Can you see that? do some small detail stuff, like the dots here. If you don't normally color, I recommend that you try it. It is so relaxing. And it focuses your energy, your attention into one thing. So it helps if you find yourself overthinking to just sit with some colors and a coloring book or something like this. And for it. That was a darker pink than I was expecting. That's okay. Let's keep going. And it's also very creative because even though you're not drawing anything from scratch, you're still, well, at least I do this, but you're still picking out colors and seeing patterns and what colors you can put together, where to put them. It's like Bob Ross would say, just put the colors where it makes you happy. And that's really all that we want, is to be happy, so don't overthink it, because you're gonna stress yourself out. And that's never fun. I am working on my next medicine video, and I don't know if anyone has actually used them as you're meant to, but I like having them out there for whoever needs them to find them, to eventually find them, because I made them with the intention to help. And I know people it's not in their interest really to go inwards. And find the uncomfortable emotions. Bring them up and heal them. I know that's not on everyone's priority list, but it's been on mine. And a lot of what I put into my medicine videos is what's actually helped me heal. So anyway, I'm working on one that I'm going to upload soon, or sorry, record soon, and this one will be about gratitude, because today, that was the theme for me, was gratitude. Every day, I take my dog for a walk in nature. Thankfully, there's a place that I can take him and he can be off leash. And we can get lost for a little. But I do have my favorite places to go, so we always end up going to the same spots. Oh no, I'm trailing. I trailed the blue. Oh no. I don't like it when that happens. Maybe I can. Happy accidents, as Bob Ross would say. I'm just gonna turn them into bubbles then, okay? Nothing to see here. Just bubbles. Normal bubbles that you find by the seahorse. Right? Okay, that looks a bit better. To be careful, these are not as quick drying as I hoped. Okay. Anyway, back to what I was talking about. Abundance. No. Gratitude. Okay. Gratitude. Okay. So, I'm going to do the light purple. So, today's theme, gratitude, right? So, as I walked, I found heart shapes in the rocks and the leaves, and I've noticed that I find them almost every day, where I just look at a certain and I see a heart, and I make it a habit to take a picture and record it. So I'll be sharing those pictures. I'm waiting to have a lot of them so I can show you all of them. So that was really great to see on the walk, on the start of the walk. And when we got to our favorite place, of all, which is by a really beautiful tree I find I have a deep connection with. I had the inkling to dance, and I had my headphones with me, so I hit shuffle and I said, play me some good songs, and my playlist started going. Grooving, you know, not really into it, but you know, warming up. And once I warmed up, I was just on fire. And the songs that followed were just perfect. It was magical. And there's this big rock that's like, it's past my height, and I'm like 5'2". So I decided to climb this big rock because it's got moss on the top, and I was barefoot because I like to be barefoot in nature if I can. It's nice out. So it's got soft moss on it, so I'm like, I'm gonna go up there. And I went up there, and then one of my favorite songs right now came on. It's called Another Lifetime by Saint Lucia. Oh my god, that song is incredible. I'll link it. But anyway, that song came on and I just went for it as if nobody was watching, because nobody was watching, so I could be as crazy as I wanted to be. And during my dance party, I started to get anxiety, and by now I can tell that when I get anxiety, it means that something that I haven't dealt with is coming up, because it wants to be acknowledged. So I incorporated the acknowledgement into my dance, which I'm pretty proud of. So I was doing a visualization while I was grooving to the music, and I was pulling this energy, this anxious energy up from my solar plexus. That's where I feel it. So I pulled it up with my hands and I bunched it up, and I was pretending to hold it at my solar plexus, and then I was pretending to pull it out of my body, and then I was pretending to hold it outside of my body, and then I grabbed it and pushed it into the rock that I was on. And I let it, and I pushed it, and I visualized it going down into the earth. and exploding, like dispersing. And then I started crying my eyes out. And the song had changed to a different song, and it was another really good song. So I'm letting myself cry as I released the anxiety. And I got back up and I kept dancing. And I felt like I wasn't alone, that I had my support system, my support team there with me, I call them my loves from the Most High, what I consider to be my spirit guides, my angels, my guardian angels, my loved ones that have passed to the other side. Oh, I hope I don't trail any more color. I'm scared to color over now. Excuse me. But anyway, I felt like they were there with me, and I felt like they were cheering me on. As crazy as that sounds, this rock, because it was so high up, I felt like I was on a stage. And I felt that my team was there with me, enjoying the music with me, dancing with me. And then when I was healing, they were supportive of me, and they were clapping for me, and I felt so grateful for that. I felt so seen and appreciated, even though I was alone, just me and my dog. I still felt so much support and appreciation from the invisible realm, from what we can't see, but we can feel. So that and some other things that happened on my walk is the reason why I want to do my next medicine video about gratitude. So there's my story about my crazy self going for a crazy dance party in the middle of the forest with my dog. I know I sound crazy, but I'm not the only one. I've recently come across a YouTube creator, tarot reader, Divine Empress 333. She has been such a genuine inspiration for me and others as well. But for me personally, she has inspired me to be myself, show my authenticity, and not be afraid of people's opinions. So if you are inclined, I would recommend you check her out. I will link her channel to the description. I will be her testimonial, one of her testimonials. Her readings have been the ones that I've felt were, for me, have been very accurate. And if you don't know what tarot is, I don't know, I don't really know what it is either. I just know that it's like, it's energy reading with cards. And tarot is very old. It's been used for a long time by people to try to get a peek into the future. But I've learned that it's not only about the future, it also can tell you about your past and your energies in the past. So the one thing about tarot that I've really enjoyed is the numerology aspect of it, and the different meanings of numbers. And I find that it's very similar to astrology in the sense that every planet and star has its story, its legend, its energy, and depending on where the planet is and where the Earth is and where the other planets are, it can mean certain things. And I find that to be so fascinating because it's quite accurate as well. And there is one astrologer I follow as well. Her name is Pam Gregory. And I find her to be a very bright light as well for humanity at this time. So if you're inclined to know about astrology, know more, I will link her as well in the description. Oh, I just love this color. This color is my favorite. If you saw my room, this color is the most prominent. It's like it's more of a turquoise than a teal. Like I thought it was first. And my favorite color is this one, and then a little bit darker, a little bit lighter. I don't know why, I just love the colors of the ocean. Maybe I was a ocean creature in another life. But yeah, back to my rant. Another thing I love about tarot is the magic, the wonderment of it. And I've been called somebody who loves the woo-woo before, so I know, okay, I know, but why would you choose not to believe in magic if you had a choice? Why would you not? I believe that seeing all the hearts on my walk and learning how to heal myself is magic. It's divine guidance. That's what magic is, just divine. It's the divine, it's spirit. Okay, I'm not done with this color yet. Don't try to put the lid on it, I'm not done. If you don't believe in magic, I invite you to actually, I dare you to go outside in nature and ask for a sign. Just go for a walk wherever in nature. And take a second to be calm, silent, and either out loud or in your head, ask for a sign. Say something like, if magic exists, send me a sign. Show me something. And see what happens. It also depends how open you are to receiving that sign, because to me, a sign could be an eagle flying over you. But to somebody else, it's just an eagle flying. So it's really to your perspective on whether or not you notice and identify the sign. Because signs are there every day in everything and anything. It's just whether or not you'd like to be open to it, and I think that's another thing I love about this life, is free will. You are free to be whatever you want. You are free to deny magic. You are free to acknowledge it and incorporate it into your life. And no one can tell you. No one can. Well, I guess they can tell you, but it's really, it comes down to you whether you want to believe them, listen to them, or listen to yourself. During my healing journey, I will tell you firsthand, as soon as you make the conscious choice to open yourself up to receive messages, guidance, signs from the divine, from spirit, you will see them. You will be guided to exactly where you need to be. And the more you listen, the more you can hear. The more you can see. Is looking so aqua-y. I love it. I think we need some pink up in here. Okay, I'm ready to put this away for now. Let's try this pink. Where do I want this pink? Wow, we're already at 43 minutes. Oh my gosh. I don't think I'm gonna finish this. Maybe I'll do a part one and part two. I'll just finish with my pink. And if anyone, I started my channel to help me learn to meditate and visualize and practice affirmations. And I haven't really achieved the meditation part. I've always had a hard time meditating. But I've heard that meditating isn't just sitting and being silent and doing nothing. Meditating can be coloring. I think the general idea is to just focus on one thing, and silence thoughts. Silence the mind. It's so freaking hard. My mind goes blah, 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 blah. So I've heard that coloring helps with meditating, and also walking in nature helps as well. these little swirlies are gonna be pink too. But yeah, like any muscle, I'm sure meditating is just practice. And I haven't really set a genuine intention to practice meditating. My life is pretty busy already, and I have so many things I want to do. So at night is really the only time I can do stuff like this, stuff for my channel and for myself, visualizing, meditating. Things to help me progress on my journey, keep me healthy, keep my energy healthy. Oh, that looks so good. Wow, I love the seahorse already. You're never too old to color. It's so much fun. So pretty. Wow, it's taking me so long to get anywhere here. But that's okay. I can do this for as long as I need to do this for. But I won't keep you here that long, so I'm gonna stop. Hope you enjoyed hanging out with me, listening to me about my crazy things, my crazy fun things. Okay, just one more color, okay? Promise. Oh. That looks really good. be my psychedelic sea pony. That's what it's called. My psychedelic sea pony. I love it. Me gusta. So yeah, expect some numerology stuff on my channel, and maybe some oracle card readings, maybe tarot, if I feel confident enough about it, because I think it takes a lot of knowledge and intuition to tap into that energy and the messages associated. But I'm open to learning, which is good. We should never stop learning. That's the whole point of being here. Learn all that you can. Have fun. But don't stop learning. Okay, I said one more color. That one more color was supposed to be the orange color. Oh, see how I can't stop. I can't stop. I'm on a roll, I told you. Where this is the last color. These little things remind me of bumblebee. I saw a couple bumblebees today. I loved it. Spring is here, yay! I've been seeing bumblebees, butterflies, hummingbirds. I haven't seen any dragons. Maybe they come later. I don't know much about dragonflies. Okay, I swear I'm done. Okay. I'm done. I can't stop. Okay, I will stop. Okay. I will do a part two, or maybe I'll just finish this and show you a completed psychedelic sea pony. Okay. Thank you for being here. I'm sending you lots of love. And I wish you all the best. And all the wonderful divine guidance on your healing journey, my friends. Remember to check out the stuff I'll link in the description and check it out if you feel drawn to. You might like it. You might surprise yourself. Alright, take care, my friends, my kings, my queens, take care.